Let's talk for a second about overcoming objections. And we talked earlier about how important it is to finish a sentence with a question. Oftentimes, that's not something that's natural for many of us, but it's a very easy skill to learn. And it'll create the dynamic when you interact with somebody that you're the asking of the question person and they're the answering person. So let me give you an example of what would be called, say, a tie down. We're just going to go through a couple skills here, just so you have this weapon in your arsenal, if you will, and your ability to communicate with people. And I would recommend that you practice this. So a question at the end of a sentence demands them to say a yes. That's what a tie down is that when you ask a question, it kind of demands a yes from them. It's a natural yes kind of a question. So let me give you an example of that. If I were to say, Mark, Ursula, getting out of debt and saving more money just makes sense, doesn't it?
Yes.
Okay. That's the difference between, thank you, by the way, that's the difference between saying, Mark and Ursula, it just makes sense to get out of debt, and I leave it there. That's a statement. But if I say, doesn't it, or isn't it, or couldn't it at the end of a sentence, or wouldn't it, that now turns that statement into a question. And now we've created that little dynamic as we're going of getting you to say yes to me. And I know this sounds very salesy, but it's true. Small yeses in a presentation typically lead to a big yes at the end. But if you're not getting little buy-ins, little yeses as you go, and you don't want to do it over and over and over again where it looks like a technique or a strategy. Again, the more you do it, the more conversational it becomes. But you can finish the sentence with doesn't it, or couldn't it, or aren't you, that kind of a thing. Or you can open it. So you could finish the tie down by saying, you're open to earning additional income in new ways, aren't you?
Yes.
Okay, that's different than saying you should be open to earning additional income. That's a statement. And then they're going to say, well, how would we do that? Or why would we want to do that? But if I finish with a question, I start to get yeses. So you're open to earning additional income, aren't you? That's a yes. That's a yes answer. There's also something called an inverted tie down, which is you put the question in the beginning of the sentence. So I could say something like, Mark and Ursula, doesn't it make sense to get out of debt and save money?
Yes.
Yes. Thank you for saying yes. So I put the question in the middle or the beginning of the sentence. Or aren't you open to looking at new ways of earning additional income? Hopefully the answer would be yes. And so I want you to learn finishing those sentences. I love to say things like, doesn't that make sense? That makes sense, doesn't it? Couldn't it? Wouldn't it? Shouldn't it? And learning to do that in your sentences rather than just respond with sentences. If you respond with a statement, they're going to respond with a question. So if I can finish my sentence with a question, typically they're going to respond with a statement, usually an affirmative if I can ask the question properly. The other thing I want you to learn is just alternative of choice. Just learning to give someone the choice between two things that are both acceptable to you. That's a question with two answers. Either the answer is a minor agreement leading towards a major decision. But it's yes, best use is for time of appointments, locations, that kind of thing. You'll notice in many of our presentations at the end of the sentence, they'll say, listen, I have a Monday or a Wednesday open. Which one of those would work better for you guys? And then they'll pick either one of them as appropriate. Or would 6 o'clock or 8 o'clock be better? Would 10% into your program or 15% be better? And so I want alternative of choice questions. It's very important that as you're asking questions to people that it not seem so canned. It's got to become, it's why you've got to practice it. It becomes more conversational. I actually have a habit in my real life now when I finish sentences often of saying, that makes sense, doesn't it? It's just because I've learned that that's how I influence people to move forward.
If you want to see an awesome clip of a young Les Brown, check it out right there next to me. I think you'll enjoy it. Continue to believe, and I'll see you there.
It was hard when just over 3 years ago, in the Penobscot building in Detroit, Michigan, where I was operating my business, and I fell on some hard times.